रैट ट्रैप बाय सलमा लागलॉफ। दिस इज अ हिंदी मूवी ऑफ द पास्ट एंड इट कैरीज द मॉरल दैट वी शुड ऑलवेज look before we leap, that is whenever we have any desire, before we fulfill that desire, we should think what will be the consequences. In this movie, the protagonist Sanjeev Kumar desires to be wealthy. He has a happy family life, but his greatest desire to be very rich. And one day God in the form of Lord Krishna appears before him, and Sanjeev Kumar places his request before the Lord. The Lord also grants his wish and promises that he will be very rich. So as God promised, Sanjeev Kumar became very rich, and he started a hotel business which flourished. But gradually, as his wealth increased, the happiness in his family life began decreasing, and he had his out of his three children, the eldest son betrays his father and starts supporting his father-in-law, and the second son falls in love with a girl and he marries her without informing his parents. The daughter also falls in love with one guy, and she becomes pregnant and brings shame to the family. So Sanjeev Kumar realizes that though he has become very rich, but he has lost the happiness in his life. So the same moral is presented in our story. The tramp. So here the protagonist is a rat trap peddler who is a tramp. There is a beggar who roams around the countryside and selling rat traps, and also begging sometimes, and sometimes when he gets the opportunity also stealing. So the tramp, he survived by selling rat traps, petty thievery and begging. His clothes were in rags. Okay, his clothes were old, torn, because he could not afford new clothes. His cheeks were sunken or hollow because he was always starving. And he led a very monotonous, that is a very boring and dreary or dull life, plodding along the roads. He was left often to his own meditations. So as he wandered around the countryside, moving from one town to the next, so he had a lot of time to think about his condition, about life in general. And so he got a lot of strange ideas. So he developed a novel philosophy that the whole world is nothing but a rat trap. It offered comforts like shelter, food, clothing, heat and luxuries, just like cheese and pork in a rat trap. It ensnared, that means it trapped anyone who was tempted to enjoy them. This thought gave him unwanted joy, that is undeserved or unreasonable joy. It became his cherished pastime, very dear pastime, because people were not kind to him. So most of the people turned down his request for food or shelter. They were very rude to him. So he got a pleasure thinking this way about them. He gloated. Okay, that is, he felt very happy having an unreasonable joy over those who had fallen in the rat trap and those who were about to. So when he looked at people, they looked wealthy, they looked happy, living in their bungalows, big houses, But he thought that he knew the miserable condition they were in. So because they wanted wealth and comforts, they had sacrificed many things in their life. Okay, maybe relaxation, maybe time with the family, maybe they were under stress. They sacrificed their peace of mind because they were wanted to become wealthy. So they got into the rat race, and because of that they gave up many things which were very dear to them. So one late evening, the tramp sought shelter at a crofter, that is a poor farmer's cottage. The lonely old man, who enjoyed company, gave a warm welcome. So this crofter lived alone. He would have lost his wife, his children might have gone away, so he was always very alone. So when this peddler came seeking shelter, he was very happy because he would get company for the night, and so he gave him a warm welcome and he offered supper and tobacco, and they played jollies, which is a card game in Sweden, and they passed. This crofter was very imprudent, unwise. He shared all his secrets. He earned a good income from the milk of his bossy. His bossy means his cow. The previous month he had earned 30 kroners. That is, a kroner is the currency of Sweden. He showed the money in a pouch which hung from a window nail. And he saved the money in a small leather pouch, and it was kept very openly on a nail on the which was on the window frame. Next morning, the host and his guest left the house early. A little while later, the tramp returned. He smashed the window pane and stole the money. He returned the pouch to its place on the nail. The tramp was in seventh heaven. That is, he was very happy because he has got a fortune. So fearing the search and arrest, he slunk. That is, he sneaked or he stole into the woods because he didn't have the courage to walk on the road, because anytime the police might come searching for him if the crofter had informed them. After a while, the paths became so confusing that he got lost. Now his weird, that is, his strange philosophy came to haunt him. That is, he started thinking, okay, that I thought that all the people around me are in the rat trap. They are tempted by many things in life, and because of that desire, they lose their peace of mind and whatever else they have. Now I have also done the same mistake. I got tempted by the money. I have stolen it. Now I have to slink like a fox, okay, like a wild animal. I have to hide. Tempted by the 30 kroner, he too had fallen in life's rat trap. The forest became his prison. It was getting dark. In utter despair, he sank to the ground and prepared himself to die. So he thought that I cannot escape from this forest. I have to starve, or I may be eaten up by wild animals. So my last moment has come. Suddenly he heard the regular thumping strokes. The hammer strokes told him that there was an iron mill or foundry nearby. That is a place where they extract the iron from the ore and make many iron implements and objects. So hearing the sounds, he realized that there was an iron mill nearby, and so if there's an iron mill, there will be people, there will be shelter. So he was very happy. Filled with hope, he ran feverishly towards the sound. In the Ramsjow iron works, the master smith and helper were waiting to put the pig iron on the anvil. So inside there were only two people, the master smith and his helper. And they were waiting to put the pig iron to the anvil. Anvil is the place where they where the iron is shaped and beaten into certain objects. Now and then they stirred the glowing mass in the furnace with a long iron bar. So the furnace is the place where the ore is heated and the iron is heated, so before it is shaped into required instruments, objects, articles. They were dripping with perspiration. The fire boy shoveled the charcoal into the maw, that is the mouth of the furnace. The sounds heard in the forge. The big bellows groaned. The bellows are these big bags, and these bags are pumped, squeezed, that is expanded and contracted, so that the air is blown into the furnace so that the fire burns steadily. So these bellows groaned as they were pumped. The burning coal cracked. So as the coal burned, it cracked into pieces. So that sound was heard. The clatter of the coal being shoveled in the maw of the furnace. The sound made by the coal pieces as they were dumped into the mouth of the furnace. The roar of the waterfall. The sharp north wind whipping against the roof. So these sounds were heard. So when the tramp entered the forge, the two workers there were not aware of him because of all these sounds. The tramp sneaked into the forge and warmed himself near the fire. The blacksmiths glanced at him indifferently, as it was a common occurrence. So this happened often. Vagabonds, tramps and beggars used to visit the forge seeking shelter for the night. So it was something which occurred often. The tramp asked for shelter. They consented haughtily. Haughtily means proudly. See, rich people may be very haughty. They may think that they are better than ordinary people. So they'll behave in a very proud manner. Okay, as if they are above others. The tramp didn't mind, as he only wanted to warm himself and sleep. The tramp was, however, not keen to enjoy the Christmas feast because he was afraid that the 30 kroner might be discovered and then the ironmaster will know that he has stolen it. The ironmaster said that his wife was dead, his sons were abroad and only his daughter was there. So he urged the tramp to come and make the Christmas food disappear. Disappear means by eating it. But the tramp was adamant, stubborn, firm in avoiding the food. The ironmaster pretended to accept his refusal and went away. The ironmaster's daughter came to the forge along with a valet, that is an assistant, you can say a butler, a person who does all kinds of jobs, okay, from top to bottom, with a big fur coat for the tramp because it was cold. She was modest and shy. Her name was Edla Wilmansen. She too invited him and assured that the tramp could leave whenever he wanted. She was very compassionate and had tearful eyes. So she said, "There is no restriction on you. You please come with us and whenever you want you can leave." So the tramp got encouraged by this offer and he agreed. So Edla's sympathy is a big factor in this story. The tramp had evil forebodings on the way due to the stolen money in his pocket. So he had an evil foreboding, that is fears. So while they were traveling in the carriage to the mansion, he started regretting having agreed to come to the mansion because he thought that again the money would be discovered and he would get into trouble. Then they reached the house. The tramp was given a room to sleep for the night, and early the next morning the ironmaster and his daughter discussed about their guest. So both were very vexed to see his condition, and they wanted to bring a permanent change in his life. So the Iron Master said, "We must give him a feast and find a permanent job for him." Edla, "I can't believe he could have fallen so low." So Edla was shocked. How could a person come to such a pitiable condition? An educated man should never come to such a condition. So she could not believe it. The Iron Master, "The tramp manners will fall away along with his tramp clothes. So when he is groomed, then you will see a total change in the tramp. Then he will appear to be civilized and cultured." But when he was neatly groomed, the Iron Master realized his blunder. The Iron Master, "What is the meaning of this? Tramp, not my fault. I never pretended to be anything but a poor trader. I wanted to stay in the forge, but no harm has been done. Let me put on my clothes and go away." The Iron Master, "I will report this to the sheriff." Sheriff means the police officer of the town. Because the Iron Master was very annoyed that he had made a mistake. "Tramp, the whole world is a rat trap. The good things are bait. You too may get caught one day." So the tramp was desperate. Because if he was examined by the sheriff would search him physically and find the 30 kroner. And then he would, the matter would become complicated, and the tramp would be charged for a greater crime. Okay, so he wanted to escape from this. So he blurted whatever came in his mind. So he blurted out his strange philosophy about the rat trap. Iron Master, "Haha, well said. Okay, I won't complain, but you get out." So the Iron Master was amused to hear such a strange philosophy, which goes against normal human opinion. Okay, so he laughed and he asked him to get out. Edla, "I don't want him to go." Iron Master, "What are you doing? Have you got a screw loose in your head?" So she wanted to display her kindness to the poor tramp. She didn't want to lose this chance. So we all know that giving is a very nice feeling. The happiness you get when you give to somebody, it's a very nice feeling. So she also was looking forward to showing kindness to the tramp the whole Christmas. So now she thought she's losing the chance. So that is why she supported the tramp. Edla, "He works throughout the year. He is chased away always. He is always afraid of being arrested. Let him enjoy peace in one day of the year." So Edla said that even one day he is unable to sleep peacefully. He may be afraid of wild animals or other thieves, or he may be afraid of being arrested by the police because you cannot sleep on the road. So he did not have a peaceful sleep. It was always disturbed, and he has to have one eye open for dangers. Iron Master, not happy, "I hope you don't regret this." The tramp was led to the dinner table where he went to work. He ate while looking often disbelievingly at Edla. So the tramp could not understand why Edla was so kind to him. So while he was busy at the dinner table, he kept looking at Edla. He slept the whole day. He never enjoyed sound sleep. So he got a chance to sleep peacefully without any danger, and he made maximum use. So he slept the whole day. At noon, they woke him up for the Christmas fair. After finishing off the Christmas fair, he went to sleep again. In the evening, when the Christmas tree was lit, they woke him. He watched with blinking eyes as the candlelight hurt them. He went to sleep again. After 2 hours, he was called to examine the fish and porridge. So all the time, in between eating, he used to sleep. So after 2 hours, he was called to analyze the fish and porridge, that is, make a serious study of the fish and porridge. Then he thanked each one present. Edla often informed him that the suit he wore was a Christmas present, and if he wanted to spend the Christmas Eve each year in peace, he was always welcome there. So Edla told that the suit which is given to you can be kept by you permanently. It's our Christmas present. And every year you can now visit us for Christmas and you can spend 2 days happily. You'll be well fed and you can sleep to your heart's desire. So the tramp was extremely flabbergasted at her kindness. He was bewildered. He was not prepared. He was taken aback. Why is she so kind to him? No one had shown such kindness. The ironmaster and the daughter went to church for the early Christmas service. When they returned, the girl was dejected as they had heard about the robbery at the crofter's cottage. So in the church, while the priest was preaching, the people there, this is the time for them to have a short nap or they will gossip among themselves. So the news about the crofter and the peddler, the rat trap peddler who had robbed 30 kroners from him, came to Edla's ears, and she realized that this thief was none other than the guest who was in their house. So she was dejected. Everybody will tease her and criticize her. Her father scolded as he thought that by now the tramp would have emptied the house of all valuables. So as they returned home in their carriage, father criticized her and he thought that by now the tramp would have stolen everything and only the walls of the house would be remaining. On reaching home, the ironmaster asked the valet whether the tramp had left. The valet replied yes and informed that he had gone empty-handed. The tramp had also left a package for Edla. Edla opened the package. She found a little rat trap with 3 10-kroner notes inside. So the valet said that the tramp has left, but he has not taken anything with him. In fact, he has left a package for Edla. In a little note to Edla, the tramp informed her that as she had been nice to him, he too wanted to be nice to her. He didn't want Edla to be embarrassed for having sheltered a thief that Christmas. He asked her to return the 30 kroner to the careless crofter. So the tramp said that, I know that people will criticize you. They will say, look at Edla, what a fool she has been to give shelter to a thief. So her Christmas would have been ruined. So he didn't want that to happen because she had been so kind to him. So that is why he returned the money to Edla and he requested her to give it to the crofter. The rat trap was his gift for her because she had set him free from the world's rat trap by treating him like a real captain. He impishly signed the note as Captain Von Stahl. So it was his gift because she was so kind to him that, and she had brought him to the house, given food, and he was able to sleep peacefully. So he had a lot of time to introspect and realize that he had done a mistake by stealing from the crofter. Because of that, he had fallen into the rat trap, and now he got a chance to escape from it by returning the money. So he wrote that letter to Edla and he signed it very impishly, that is mischievously or naughtily, displaying his sense of humor as Captain Von Stahl, because he was treated like a captain. So the moral's message in this story are: the kindness and empathy reformed the tramp and rescued him from the rat trap his greed had pushed him into. Genuine love and generosity can reform anyone on this earth. Look before you leap. So before you take a decision, so you think twice about the consequences. Don't be swayed by your desires. Choose the right set of goals which are suitable for you. Muddled dreams that is the confused dreams which are not suitable for you may lead to disaster.